Paul.
Hello, I'm Paul.
This patient has been sent by his GP for an ultrasound investigation of the heart. Ultrasound has a number of key advantages. It's quick, cost-effective, and has virtually no associated hazards. It's also far more acceptable to many patients than some other modalities. ECG electrodes are attached to the patient to record the electrical signals from the heart. This allows the ultrasound images to be linked to the heart cycle.
Okay, and what I'd like you to do now for me is roll onto your left-hand side. That's just so your lungs drop out of the way for me, because I can't see through air. Okay. Nice and relaxed. I'm just going to do a quick scan to see if your heart structure for you.
Because even a thin layer of air will reflect the ultrasound signal, a coupling gel is used between the ultrasound transducer and the patient. Ultrasound is useful for rapid and reliable cardiac investigations, particularly as it's the only technique that can provide information about blood flow. However, as ultrasound doesn't penetrate bone, the transducer has to be shaped so that the ultrasound beam will pass between the ribs. The transducer being used in this examination is a wide-band transducer that transmits ultrasound at 1.75 MHz, a low enough frequency for good penetration of the heart. The images are formed by detecting the reflected second harmonic at 3.5 MHz. This gives a good compromise between spatial resolution and sensitivity. Paul has produced a parasternal view of the heart. First, a standard B-mode image. Now he has chosen a direction from the B-mode image to look at in M-mode. This allows the position of different parts of the heart to be plotted against time. By moving into colour Doppler mode, the blood flow through the heart can be visualised. Ultrasound reflected by blood flowing away from the transducer returns with a slightly lower frequency and shows up blue on the images. Conversely, blood flowing towards the transducer is shown in red. Moving to the apex of the heart, Paul uses a different Doppler technique. The frequency shift depends on the blood flow velocity. So a plot of frequency shift against time indicates flow velocity as a function of time. And this is plotted in yellow. Because the frequency shift is in the audible range, it can also be sent to a loudspeaker, and a trained operator can use the sound for diagnostic purposes.
Okay, that's it. All done. If you want to wipe all the jelly off and get dressed again, I'll send a report to the cardiologist and he'll go through it with you at your next outpatient appointment.
Excellent.
Okay.
Yep. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, now we've collected the data from the patient, we can have a look and analyse the images that we've picked up. This first image is a 2D long-axis parasternal view. It shows us the structures on the left heart predominantly, with the left atrium, the mitral valve, the left ventricle, the septum and posterior walls, and the apex is generally cut off, LV outflow tract, aortic valve, ascending aorta, and we also see a little bit of the right ventricle at the top there. From this image, we can actually take a slice through the image and look at it over time and see how it changes in motion. This is an M-mode view. This is the 2D image at the top with the line showing where we're cutting to generate our M-mode picture. This is the change across the line over time. So we're going through the aortic valve and the left atrium. So you can see the left atrium at the bottom as it contracts and relaxes over time. And you can see the aortic root, and you can see the aortic valve opening and shutting with the central closure line in line with systole in the ventricles. We can use M-mode anywhere across the 2D sector to demonstrate motion or to make accurate measurements. In this final view, we've taken information relating to blood flow velocity through the pulmonary valve. We use pulse wave Doppler because generally it's less than 1 meter per second. Anything faster than that and it tends to alias and we get inaccurate data. If it was over a meter per second, we'd tend to use continuous wave, which can cope with the higher frequencies. This is a Doppler trace from this 2D image, and we've got the cursor going through and we're actually using pulsed wave Doppler, which is focused just past the pulmonary valve. From this image, it demonstrates velocity over time, and what the machine actually does is measure Doppler shift in frequency and plots it as a graph of velocity over time for us. And you can see that the pulmonary forward flow, or flow away from the transducer, is about 1 meter per second. Thank you.